Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see how we can extract a fluid domain from a SolidCAD model. Like in this example, we are going to take a pipe. So this pipe is a CAD model. So when I say CAD model, the pipe is going to be of the solid model, right? The solid surfaces. But for running a fluid simulation, that is CFD, we don't need the solid surface. Instead, we need the fluid domain, but in a CAD model that would just be an empty space. So we can use ANSYS Space Claim, which is a module of ANSYS, to extract the fluid domain from the SolidCAD model. Now we will see how to do that. I'm in my workbench. I'm going to drag and drop fluid flow fluent. In the geometry, I will right click and first I will import my geometry. To view the geometry, I will right click and edit geometry in Space Claim. Let it open. Now my model is opened in Space Claim. Now you can see that I have this model of a pipe, but this is for a structural, right? Because the surface which we have is of solid and all these holes and everything is used to calculate stresses in a structural simulation. But this is not what we want for a fluid simulation. We want to have a surface or a volume that will be of the inside of the pipe so that we can run a fluid simulation. Now we will start with cleaning up the geometry. To do that, first you can go to repair and then you can check whether your body needs any stitch or gap, and you can check one by one. Okay, so you can press one by one and on the bottom you can see the information, no areas found. So if there are any areas found, then we might have to work on it. See, now we have four areas found for simplify. Just press tick. If it resolves, it's okay. If it doesn't, it's okay. Like for starting, then we have 16 inexact edges. Then I press tick and it fixed 12 problems. It was not able to do the other four. It's okay. Like we are just starting out. Now we go to prepare and then here just select faces, because now we are going to remove these chamfers, because these chamfers are not needed for us. So first I'll press this, click on the tick. You can see that the chamfer is gone. Similarly, we have a chamfer here. I'll press on this, click tick, then the chamfer is gone. And we also have chamfer over here and here. If you want to select two faces, just hold control and select, then tick, it is also gone. So let's see the other side if we have any chamfer. No, we don't. Now our geometry, okay, we have one here. Now our geometry doesn't have any chamfers, but still it has these holes which do not contribute to the fluid, because anyways it will be sealed, right? It's for some screws or mounting anything. It's not of our concern to do any CFD simulation there. So we can close that as well. To do that, in the prepare, you select the faces and then select the inner surface of the face and click on tick. You can see that the face is gone. Similarly, we don't need this as well, so click on that. We have one more hole like that, so click on that and click tick and it is gone. See, we don't have anything. Now we have only the pipes which we need to create the geometry. Now what you have to do is you have to close these ends. Like if you see this whole pipe, it is okay, like it is a single body, but due to the welding or anything we have a bit of gap here. So this is instead a three body and not a single body, right? The body on the bottom is different, this is different and this is different. So we can't use all those three to extract the fluid domain at the same time. So we have to treat it as a separate entity. Now in that case, if you see, this body is a separate body and it has a hole, so which is like defect, just like how we resolved the holes in the beginning. This is also a type of defect, so we will close this hole as well and also this. do not worry that we will merge the volume later. Now if you see, we have this pipe, this separate pipe, and this as a separate pipe. Now we can start extracting the fluid domain for every single pipe. Now for this, on the left panel I just disabled the view for the other two. Now in the prepare, you can press volume extract and you select this box. Okay, now this is going to ask you to select faces. This select faces that seal an enclosed region. So in this example, this would be this face, rotate it, hold the control and then select the other face also. Now you press this button, you know, this button is called seed face. So this will select, we have to select a face which will determine the inside of the enclosed volume. So I'll press this, and in our case this is the inside of the enclosed volume. So I'll press this and press tick. Now you see we have got a solid body which is like a volume inside this. Now I will hide the solid body, we have only the volume, right? We have the volume for the first pipe. Now I'll hide this volume as well. Now we will go to the second pipe, which is this. If you see here, again we can generate the volume here, extract the volume. So the first phase, rotate, hold control, select this also, go here and then select the seed phase, click tick, we have got the next volume, right? Now we have two volumes, but we need the third volume in the bottom, and that is a bit tricky. See, first we have this, the process is same. First select this phase, then this phase, then we need the seed phase. We got it, right? Now how is it tricky? When I show all these three volumes, you can see that there is a bit of gap here, because the way the pipe was generated, it had a curve here, so it is not able to merge it completely, but here it was able to, right? So we are going to fix this. To fix this, first we have to create a single volume. To do that, we have to merge this face with that, because we know that is how it is going to work, right? Now you go to design on the top, make sure to select this face, then press pull. Okay, now you can pull this on top until it merges completely with this solid. Technically there is a fluid, but in our case it's solid. Okay, so that volume has been merged with that. Now we have the volume also. Again we will go to the repair, and actually we have done everything, we don't need the pull anymore. Okay, now if you go to design, we have this button called combine. Just press all these three. Okay, now these are the ones which we are going to combine. Okay, now this won't do much, but it's okay. Now in the repair, you start with stitch, no areas found. Again in gaps, no missing face, no split edges, no extra, no duplicates. You can see it here, same for other option. Now you see initially we had some inexact faces, now we don't have. That's why I told you, you don't have to worry in the beginning. Now we go to prepare, and start with interference, we don't have anything. Rounds, again we don't have anything. Short edges, bad faces, sharp edges, clearance, nothing. Everything is all right, we don't have any problem with anything at all, right? Now we have just these three, which is the fluid volume, and we don't have any problem at all. Now we will check whether it is meshing properly without any errors. Only when we mesh it, we will know whether it has any errors or not. So I will open the mesh module. Okay, here if you go to geometry, we are able to see all these three, which are the solids. So what you can do is you can select all these three, right click, suppress body, you can do that. Or else in the space claim itself, you can go here, select all these three, right click and suppress for physics. Anything works. OK, Okay, so since we already opened our mesh, I will do it here. Okay, now we have only this volume. We can see that here in the space claim it was three different volumes, but since we combined, it is a single volume here. I'll go to this volume and you see these are some properties. Can go to mesh and I have multiple processes, so I'll give 16. That is the amount of threads I have in my PC. Click on generate. Yes, we have got a good mesh. You can see that these two bodies are merging properly in terms of nodes. If these were separate bodies, then these nodes will not merge like this, right? Now we don't have any nodes that is not merging with the other part. Now this is fine. So you can, there is also another way to check whether everything is working fine. First I will now kind of refine the mesh just to check if everything works fine. Yes, everything works fine. But also you can try to add inflation layers. So if there are any gaps between the bodies, then inflation layer will give you errors. So insert, you go for inflation, and for the geometry we want for this entire volume. So I'll select this, like make sure that you have selected this body, select this and click on apply. For boundary we need on this face, hold control and press these three faces. Like these are the three faces where we need inflation layers, because technically these are the walls. I'll click that. So my maximum layers is 5. That is okay, because this is just for testing. Give generate. That is good. Meshing is done. Click on mesh. You can see that the 5 layers were added without any problems and it is merging properly. Similarly, you go here. Here also everything is merging properly. Right? Everything is fine. So we don't have any problems with the meshing also. So our geometry is fine. Now you can add the named selection and everything. So I hope this video was useful for you in learning how to extract volume using space claim from any CAD geometry. Now you can try this for any geometry, like literally anything. Even if you have a bottle and you want to extract a fluid domain from for the bottle, you can still do the same thing. So it works for any case. Space claim is very powerful. If you want to remove any nuts, bolts, screws from your geometry, it will still work. You can click on faces and try to remove it from space claim. Thank you. See you in another video.